Hi there, welcome to Stand on Guard. I am so happy you're with me today. I believe this is a teaching that you're going to want to watch again and get some of your friends to watch. It's one of the keys from the book, Six Keys to Breakthrough and Healing. God wants you not only to prosper in your body, in your soul, but He wants to bless you financially, and He gives us the keys for it. But I do believe there's some things that will block. If we don't live in obedience, then how can we expect to walk in blessing? The Bible says in Malachi chapter 3, if we refuse to tithe and give offerings, we're robbing God. Well, it always amazes me of how many people, they don't tithe, they don't give in offerings, and in fact, they don't do anything according to the principles, and yet when they get in trouble, they go to God and they expect God to do His part, and many times He does. To me, it'd be like if you go down to the store in the corner of your street or nearby in your neighborhood, and every week you went down and you robbed from that store, and the owner or the manager of the store saw you robbing every week, and then you got into a real crisis, and so you go back to that man and you say, could you please help me? I'm really in trouble. You know, for that man to actually help you, knowing that you'd been stealing from him all year, would be amazing. The fact is, God is much nicer than the man at the store or me or you. God does bless people that don't do any of the principles. But I find it's just hit and miss. It wasn't until I came into living in obedience and living in these principles that I started to live and walk in consistent blessing. I don't want you blessed just once in a while. I want you to live in blessing. God wants you to have all your bills paid. He wants you to be out of debt, and He wants you to be well. And you say, well, are you saying that I have to tithe and I have to give offerings in order to be healed? Well, you know, we're not talking about buying your healing. There's not enough money in the world to pay for your healing. And God does heal people who don't tithe and don't give. And that's the mercy of God. But the fact is, if you want to live in consistent blessing, then you've got to be consistent in just obeying the rules. If you look at the Bible, I quote this in Six Keys to Breakthrough and Healing, the book in Matthew, Mark, Luke, those three books, the first three books of the New Testament, one out of every six verses deals with money. And then, you know, people come to church and say, why are you talking about money? Because it's important. It's not about money. It's about your heart. You find out where people's heart is. You find out what their attitude is when you start talking about money. And the fact is, the parables Jesus taught, there are 29 parables written in the Gospels, and 16 of them deal with the issue of people and their money. So I think it's really important. Now, I just want to share a quick personal story because I'm still learning this too. You know, we've always tithe. We've always give 10% of everything that comes in. We believe that's God. It's a way of honoring God. We don't give because we have to. We give because we really want to honor God. And we're the first fruits, as the Bible says. Well, a few years ago, Gwen and I were at the Miracle Channel doing a partner week with our friends Dick and Joan DeWert. And Dick had come up with a number from Scripture and was encouraging people to give several thousand dollars to sow into that ministry. Well, we'd intended on doing something, but not that much. And God spoke to me and told me we were to sow that very amount, even though we didn't have it, and even though we were in a financial crisis ourselves. And we had bills that we didn't look like we could pay. We had a trip coming up to Russia. We were going to establish video churches, DVD churches, had no money for that. And the enemy was saying, you're not going to be able to do any of this and your work's going to fall apart. He's an absolute liar. This was the end of November. And so I said, we need to give. And the fact is, we owed the Miracle Channel a lot of money. We owed them a lot of money for airtime. And so I said, we don't have the money. But I believe God spoke to me. According to Malachi chapter 3, it's not just robbing God by not tithing. When God speaks to you about giving a specific offering and you don't do it, then you're robbing Him. And so I went on the air and I said, I believe God's speaking to us to do it. And we're making this commitment. We're making this pledge. And as God meets the need, we're going to give it to the Miracle Channel. And I'm encouraging people that God's speaking to that don't have it, but have the faith to believe that God's going to provide it. Well, the phones went crazy. Gwen and I prayed with people for probably an hour or more that night on the phones. And the next morning, somebody sent in an offering to our ministry, put it on their credit card for exactly that amount. We send it to the Miracle Channel, and the proof is in our books. Let me tell you, the month of December that year was the highest income of any month in the history of our ministry. God just opened the heavens. Not only were we able to pay all our bills, but we had more than enough money to go to Russia, set up all the DVD churches. I mean, this works, and we have proven it. I'm encouraging you today to just prove God. And if you want to walk in absolute blessing of God, body, soul, spirit, then you better get with the program. Probably want to get the book, Six Keys to Breakthrough and Healing. You can order it here on the website. God bless you. Love you.